Hello students, let us look at one of the problem of maximum power transfer theorem. So find the value of resistance RL in the circuit which is given for maximum power transfer and calculate the maximum power transfer. So we have to find out what should be the value of RL for maximum power transfer and what should be the maximum power that is being transferred. So for that we have to first draw the circuit and remove the load resistance RL. So let me write that step one, remove RL. Next is step two is find VTH and RTH. So first let me remove RL, that is the first step. So I'm going to remove RL, so that is now gone, and whatever remains there we have to find out VTH. So this is going to be plus minus VTH. Okay, so obviously we all know how to do it. First we have to find out what is the current here. Here the current is going to be zero. So if you find out what is the current here, then we will be able to write. So let me write that value as I. So first KVL at mesh 1. Okay. Now why I am doing KVL at mesh 1? Because if I know this current, then I will be able to find out what is the voltage across this. And then the voltage across this, this and this, if I put it in a mesh equation, I will get what is VTH. Okay. So for finding out what is the voltage across this, all I have to do is find out this current I. So for that, if I am writing the KVL, then this is going to be plus minus, this is going to be plus minus. This is already plus here. So this is going to be minus 3 plus 2I. Plus 2i, there is no i2 because i2 is going to be 0 here. So I can write minus 0. If you want to write, you can write. I will not write minus 0. Then plus 6 is going to be equal to 0. Therefore 4i is equal to minus 3, and from where I get, therefore I is equal to minus 3 divided by 4. Okay, minus 3 divided by 4. What does that minus mean? Minus means that the current that we have taken, it should have been taken in the opposite direction. But that does not matter because minus is there. So automatically it will take care of the direction. So next I have to write whatever is the voltage in VTH. For that I have to write KVL at mesh 2. So KVL at mesh 2. Now listen here. This is plus, this is minus. Here already I is only flowing and I have already written what is plus and minus here. So I will not change that. Now based on that, I can write here, taking from front of the element, I will write 6 plus 2i plus VTH. Plus VTH, not plus VTH, minus VTH, isn't it? Because I am taking from front of the element. So it is going to be minus VTH minus 10 is going to be equal to 0. But I, we have already found out, I is minus 3 by 4, isn't it? So it is going to be 6 plus 2 times minus 3 by 4 minus VTH minus 10 is equal to 0. From where I can write VTH, if I take the other side, I will get 6 minus 10 is going to be minus 4. Then I am going to have minus of 2 and 4 will cancel off. So minus of 3 by 2. Okay. Which, as you all know, we can get it as minus 8 minus 3 divided by 2. from which I will get the value of VTH as minus 11 by 2, which becomes minus 5.5 volts. So it just means that it should be in opposite direction. Okay, it should be in opposite direction, that we have to take care. Okay, then next is finding RTH. So first I have to find out VTH. So VTH I have found out. Next I am going to find out RTH. Okay, for RTH I will have to again redraw the circuit, but this time I will have to avoid all the voltage as well as, there is no current source here, so I will have to avoid all the voltage source. So this is going to be short circuit. This is 2 ohms. Then here I am having 2 ohms, and this is also going to be short, and here there is voltage source which again I am going to short it. So if I am going to look from here for RTH, RTH is basically going to be 2 parallel 2. So RTH is 2 ohms parallel with 2 ohms, which we all know if two similar resistances are considered in parallel, their value will be half of that resistance, which is 1 ohm. Okay, have I missed something here? No. Okay. So I will have to draw the equivalent circuit, the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So the Thevenin's equivalent circuit will come as VTH. Now see, VTH is going to be minus. So generally I would have drawn this one big and this one small, but now I have to reverse it. Why? Because it is minus. So this is going to be the VTH. So VTH is going to be 5.5. Okay, either I can draw it like this, or I can draw like this and write it as minus 5.5, but it's the same meaning. So I am just drawing the battery opposite. So positive down, negative up, and then I am having RTH. RTH is equal to 1, and then to that I am connecting load resistance. Now what is the load resistance? RL. Okay, the load resistance, now I am going to connect the load resistance RL, and that RL should be equal to RTH, which is 1 ohms. Okay, so now what is maximum power? So the step 2 was over. Step 3. Okay, let me write that. Step 3, Pmax. Step 3 is finding out Pmax. And what is the Pmax equation? Pmax is VTH square divided by 4 RTH. Simple. See, so even if your VTH is plus or minus, it does not matter, isn't it? Therefore, Pmax is going to be VTH, which is 5.5 the whole square, divided by 4 times 1. RTH is 1. So this will give me an answer, 7.56 watts. Okay, now remember here we have taken voltage as volts. If it would have been millivolt, then I would have to write it in terms of voltage as into 10 raised to power minus 3, and also take care that, you know, it is watts. Watts comes if you are having voltage and ohms for VTH and RTH. Okay, thank you.